Well, hello, guys and gals, and welcome back to another edition of Scrap Mechanic with me, your old buddy, Mr. Moose. And today we are going to be working on building a new house. I know, the last video was all about my house, right? Well, it's driving me nuts, the fact that that thing didn't work out quite right. So we're going to do it again. And this time, we'll change a few things up, and hopefully this time I will be making it work properly. So let's get to it. We're going to start by putting down our trusty little jack here on the ground, because we do need to start with it on it. And I will place a piece of wood on here. I'm going to rotate that so it's flat, and that way I can just come all the way out and over, and that is maxed out as big as it will go. I'll do the same thing again every time to make our initial platform. There we go. And one more time here. Yeah, there we go. All right, that is our initial platform here that is going to be part of our house. And then I'm going to come off the back of it, and I'm going to do the same thing one more time. I've got a different idea for this one, but it's basically going to be the same thing. All right, now at this point, I want to change the angle of my piece so that it shows me that it's going up and sideways. And I want to go all the way up, over, there we go. Got a wall. Do the same thing again, coming down all the way over. Down and over, and another wall. Do the same thing over here on this side. Up, over. Ooh. Building the walls. A little short dude can't really go very high. All right, up, over, up, and over, and there you go. And then we'll close in the back of it here. To do that, I need to change the angle on that. Dangle there. And there. And there. So now we have a box. To the sides of the box, we need to put some bearings in. And we're going to space 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and one more. Oops, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then 1. Come over here, do the same thing. Start there and come in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and one more. There we go. I'll do the same thing on the opposite side. Come in here, boom, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and one to go on. And then over on this side, I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and one to go on. There we go. And that is the beginning. Now, to build our little foundation that we're going to do, we're going to come in here. We're going to need a couple of pieces. And I'm going to try to recreate it the same way I did before. So I need an angle piece. I need this piece, might need that piece, and I need a bearing, and I need a big honking wheel. So where's that big honking wheel at? There's the big honking wheel. That'll work. All right, so basically we start with elbows. Put on an elbow, put on an elbow, put on another elbow. Oh, they changed the drill. That's cool. New drill. Raise our house a little bit. Now we need to be able to steer these, so we need to put a bearing in here first. Bing! And another bearing in here. Bada bing, bada boom. Let's raise those up a little bit more. Put another bearing, and yet another bearing. And then we'll come over here and do the same thing over here. So we'll get our little piece out, hook it to there, come over here. Oh, not there. Come here. Oh, that's a cool looking new drill we got. All right, let's put some bearings in. Another bearing and a bearing. And another bearing and another bearing. And there we go. So bearing, bearing, everybody's got a bearing. All right, so now we put that in place. Put that in place. Put that in place. Well, that goes in place. Then we raise her up a little bit more. We put another little pipe piece on here. Let's make sure that we got it going the right direction. Oh yeah, that's good. That's good there. That's great. Wonderful. Nice. Everybody's looking good. Let's go ahead and do one more connection here. So we're putting a bearing. A bearing. Yet another bearing. Another bearing. And then we put wheels. Wheel. 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 If I calculated all this out, all this is going to work. Hopefully the spacing's right. All right, so let's get back over here and do the same thing all over again. Wheels, wheels, more support, support, another support, and more wheels. Oops, nope, not, oh, wait, did I do that right? Oh yeah, I did it right. Let's make sure that we get that on there. All right, so elbow, turn the elbow around using the Q button. Put that one on there. And there, and that one there. Grab our bearings, put them in place. Oh yeah, oh yeah, we're good. All right, come on up here, put a wheel on. Got a wheel, got another wheel, got another wheel, and another wheel. Nice. All right, so if we put it on the ground at this point, everything would collapse, because the wheels don't have any, or the bearings don't have any tension on them. So we come into here, we're going to get a controller, and we're going to throw that onto our little thing here. We can put it on, well, we don't need the wheels anytime soon. So we're going to come here, and we're going to get our little controller box, and we are going to flip it around a couple of times so that it shows us the front. Oh yeah, because I like to see the little dots and little buttons and gizmos. All right, and I'll go ahead and put another one up here for now, because we're going to need two of them. And then we're going to get our little whirly dude out, and we're going to connect to each of these top bearings at this point. So I'm going to connect there. One, two, three, and four. Nice, that's there. And then we want to come over here, and aiming at that same purple little thing, we're going to come over here and go 5, 6, and 7, and we can do a total of 8 to the controller. I think actually you can do 10. All right, so that is there. All of our bearings are now connected to our little box. So the next thing we need to make is make sure our directionals are going the same way on each of the ones that we're going to be using. Now, these are going to fold up, so I want to make sure that all of them are red folding up and blue folding down. So red up, red up. This one would be need to be reversed, so I'll right click on it. And right click on that one, because again, folding up on these are going to fold them forward. Those are going to fold backwards. And I'm going to do the same thing on this side. Again, these want to fold forward. So I want to make sure that the red is going forward. Red is going forward. These are going to fold backwards. So the red needs to go backwards. Red needs to go backwards. Nice. So that's good. All right. So if we come over here in E, we want to set this up so in our open position, they are completely folded up. So each one of these bearings is going to have to rotate. So one, and we're going to go red on all of these because they're all in the same position. They're all going to fold 90 degrees to the red. There we go. Come on, 90. 90. Again, 90 again, 90 again, and one more time, 90 again. So in their open position, they will, or in their base position, they will go to 90 degrees counterclockwise or towards the red. Now, when we want them open, we want to do the exact same opposite. We want them to go 90 degrees to the open. All right. Because now the one thing about the bearings are, when you put the bearings on, however you put them on and they initiate, that is the way they work. So at this point, when you add the connection to them, with them hanging down low like they are, they're going to automatically, that's going to be their natural position. So with that set, what I mean is, if I put these on and they were hanging to the side, their natural tendency would be to the side, and you would, that would be zero, would be right here. And all you're doing is you're taking your bearing from zero one way or the other. So right here, zero is straight up and down. So in its naturally open position or switch off, I'm telling it I want that wheel to be placed perfectly parallel to the base of the house. So I'm rotating it 90 degrees down. Now, but when I turn the switch on, I want the switch to rotate it back 90 degrees down, so it's at zero. So, and that's kind of how that works. So everything is now done. We just need a switch. If I put a switch up here on the wall, like so, not a motor, a switch. If I put a switch right here, I connect said switch to that box. There we go. That is ready to go. And if I delete out this stand, the whole thing falls down because, again, we're off. But if I come over here, get rid of this, and I turn the switch on, the house will stand up. Now, all the wheels are spinning around because they still don't have any steering or anything else like that. But we're getting started. Nice. Nice, 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 nice. We're just getting started here. All right. So, what's next? That's just the basics. I'm liking it so far, though. I'm liking what we got going so far. All right, let's set her down on the ground one more time, which this is going to freak out a little bit because all the wheels are kind of weird. They're going to flip around and do whatever. Once we get a steering mechanism on it, it will work much better. So let's go in here now that it's sitting on the ground. We don't have to jack it up anymore because we've already got a jack thing going. Let's do this. Let's get our wooden block out. Put it on here. And let's go ahead and block off the front of this house. And to do that, I need to rotate that around a little bit. And bring that down like so. And bring that down like so. And then we want to put a window in this thing. So let's go. And do it a little bit different this time. Let's see, what would be a good window? I think really all I got for a window is this arch. I really don't have, this thing's just massive, huge, the large structure support. This support structure seems to work really good for a window. So we'll throw it in here. And we'll just kind of look at it and see how it looks by trying to put it up against the wall. There we go. And we'll say for the window, I think that right there is going to be a pretty good area. So what I'll do is I'll start taking out the area in which that window needs to fit until I see I got the width and it's 4 high. So I need to take out one more row. Boom. And now I can set a window in place. Boom. Got a window. Now we need a door next to that window. I probably should have put that, I don't know. That's not too bad. Not too bad. I'll take it. I'll take it. I'll take it. I'll take it. All right. So that's going to be our window there. Couch here. Oh, yeah. All right. So we need a door. So let's make a door. Door-wise. Excuse me, had to sneeze though. Take out Let's take out that for a door. Eh, is that going to work for a door? Eh, it'll work for a door. And then we can put a window right next to it. One, two, over. So I like to be a little symmetrical with this. One, two. There we go. Take all that out. Probably have that door way over too far. Let's see. One, two, three. Let's take out those two there. Take out that door or window there. And then let's go over one, two, three. Let's put that back in. And I need to take one of these out. Oh, yeah. I'm pretty indecisive on this stuff. It takes me a while to figure out just how I want to build it. Hey, come on now. Bingo. There we go. And let's put this one in place over here. And then we can fill in the cracks here with wood there, with there. And then the distance between that, one, two, take out that. And then put that one back in. There we go. That can be where our door goes in. Okay. Get a little bit of a structure here. Yeah, well, you know. All right. We got a little awning there. Oh, yeah. We're rocking along. So here we go. Nice. All right. So right here, we're going to start our little stairwell thing to go up to a second floor. Let's do it like, say, how I want to do this. You know what? For now, there we go. For now, I'm going to put my little seat right here. I'm not going to really worry about doing anything with it right this minute, but I am going to turn it a little bit. There we go. No, that's the wrong way. I don't want to face that direction. Boom, there we go. All right, now I got a seat so I can start rigging up some controls to some of these wheels. All right, so let's get some steering rigged up here. And to do so, we'll go from the green dot to that bearing there. That straighten that one up. All right. And then we'll go from, same thing, from that green dot to that top bearing there. That'll give us some steering there. Come on now. Give me the ball. All right. So we come back here. I want to hit that bearing. And I want to grab that bearing. And can I hit it? I got it. There we go. Now we got a little bit of steering going on. Let's go ahead and get this thing up off the ground. Rank. This is all temporary. It just helps to get everything somewhat rigged. Oops, that's not what I wanted to do. Jump down. All right, so we'll grab that. And again, we're going to these top bearings. Yeah, which are steering bearings. There we go. And this will get rid of our wanting to collapse thing. All right. So next thing we have to do on these bearings is make sure they're all turning in the right direction. So let's see. That one's going that way. That one's going that way. That's fine. And this one's going the wrong way. And that one's going the wrong way. Front ones need to go that way. That way. And the back ones need to go that way. I think that's right. I do believe that's the correct way. If we jump up here and I turn that way, those turn that way. And if I turn that way, those turn that way. And let's see if we can get out here so I can see the back. Oh yeah, those are turning in the right direction. Oh yeah. Make sure this side's right. Up, up. We're all turning good. Sweet. All right. So far, so good. We got a little turning going on. We got a little collapsing going on. Now with that tension on those bearings, when we lower the house down, guess what? It all folds up real nice and neat. Everything sits down on the ground real nice and neat. Oh, yeah. Oh, we need to go a little bit past 90, though, because it's still not completely flat on the ground. Though that might not be a bad idea. Let's go a little past 90 so we can get it completely on the ground. So let's go E here. And we'll go up to 105 on these. Because that's not getting us all the way on the ground at 90. So 105 should get the house completely on the ground. And then we'll have to do the same thing here since that's going past 190. We'll have to make sure this goes to 105. There we go. 105. There we go. Close that out. Oh yeah, it's on the ground now. We heard that go bonk. So raise it up, put her down. Raise her up, put her down. Very cool. Alright, so the next thing we want to do is we want to work on camouflaging these so the whole world doesn't know that, well, these wheels are in here. And that's what we do with the brick columns that we put around the outside that we planted the little dealy-doos on that time. Now to do that, what I want to do is come over here and on the side of the house, I'm going to put a wooden block. I'm going to put a bearing. I'm going to put a bearing right about here. And I'm going to put an angle piece on it. And I want to change that angle piece. One thing I want to do with this is very important. When you're building this, anything you want to build like at a particular like parallel to the house, you want to start with the bearing already on the controller, because if you don't, as soon as you put something on the bearing with any kind of weight, it'll make the bearing fall down. So go ahead and put some tension on your bearing by hooking it to the controller. And now that I've done that, I can change this piece around to that angle there. I can put this little piece on it like so. Actually, I don't want to raise it up too high, so let's get a stubby little piece in here. Let's get that piece. Let's get that, hook that there. Then we'll put an angle piece on like so. We'll put a bearing on the inside of that piece like so. We'll put another end cap on it like so. Another shorty. Oops. See, I didn't put any tension on that bearing, so it rolled down like that. Go ahead and put the tension on the bearing like that. There we go. Come back here, get my angle piece. I'll flip it around like so. I'll put my last bearing on here. Bada bing, bada boom. And then, again, I'm going to be building stone off of this. So let's go ahead and get the stone brick piece that we're going to be using. Drop that there. And again, we want to put tension on that bearing before we hook to it. So there we go. And I'm going to put the little piece of stone on there. Nice. I need to come out one more with that piece of stone so it clears the tires. And if I change this, and this is very important when you're doing this, make sure that you're building off of that stone and not building off of the house, because, oops, that's not what I want to do. trying to, oops, not, no, no, yeah, there, oh, no, that's what I want to do. There we go. And we'll pull that over like so. And we'll get that all the way past the tire to the end of the house, like that. All right, and I need to be able to see in here to work. So for now, we'll just get rid of that. All right, so with this built out the way it is, I need a switch. And I'll put the switch down here. We'll put it right there for now. I should put that where the window was. I'll put that switch over there like so. Connect that switch to that box. There we go. All right, so I don't have to do anything with the closed position because in the closed position, because we went ahead and applied current to each of the bearings before we built onto them, they're all in their natural position the way that it is closed. So all we have to do now is open it up. So what I want to do is I want to make sure all of my bearings are rotating the same way. So this one to rotate up, I want to be blue. For this one to rotate, I want to be up. So I want it to be blue that way because I want it to rotate up. So as this one's rotating up, this one's rotating this way up, and this one will be rotating, you think? Hang on. I'm trying to visualize this in my head. This one I want to rotate down. All right, I got it. I got it. All right, so here's what we want to do. Each of these needs to open up 45 degrees. Is that right? That one's going to go up 45. That one's going to go up 90. All right, so the first one's going to go up 45 degrees. I know that much. That one's going to go up 45. This one's going to go up 180 degrees, right? I think that's right, 180. And this one's going to go 45. Gosh, I could be completely wrong on this. No, it's going to be 90. That one's going to go 90 degrees. And this one's going to go 90 degrees. I'm trying to do the math in my head while I talk about this. Well, part of that worked. Part of it went up, part of it didn't. What happened wrong here? Two didn't do nothing. All right, wait a minute. 90, 180, and 90. Let's do this. Let's get rid of some stuff for right now so nothing is possibly catching on anything. If some of the stuff is like catching, it won't work. So let's make sure nothing's in a bind. Come on. Delete. There we go. Now let's hit it and see what it does. Well, that ain't right. That ain't right there, Moosey. I should have gone. Let's think about this for a second. I went the wrong direction, I bet. Let's see. Instead of going that way, that one's going up. That's going up. That needs to go down. Ah, got the direction wrong. Change the direction. Hit it. Ah, oh, there we go. That's it. All I had to do was change the direction. Now it works perfectly. So see, it just goes straight up and down now. Bada bing, bada boom. All right, cool. Now all I got to do is take that back in. So I take my little thing, put that there. Now all I got to do is block all this in. Again, working off of the existing block. Don't work off of the house or something like that. Otherwise, you'll have problems. Here, drag that out to the end of the house plus one, really. And then I'll flip that around and I just drag that to the edge of the house And we'll do the same thing over here. Grab off the top, come down, go one over. And that should work perfectly. So let's try that. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, it's working. It's working again. Man, now all I've got to do is replicate the entire thing back on the other side. So we'll come back over here. And we'll get somewhere around the center. And we'll do the whole thing over again. I think we started right here, right? So, ooh, is that it? Did I start one over the... let's see. I think I started actually on the exact edge of the wheels. So, yeah. I started on the same line as the height of the wheels. Nice. All right. So, we'll put this in place. Boom. And again, now is the fun part. You got to get your little ray gun, and shoot that bearing with the ray gun. There we go. Come back over here. Put our piece of pipe on that, and we'll go that direction with it. Put a piece of pipe on there, like so. We'll put our end cap on it, rotate it around, put another bearing on there. See if we can hit our ray gun to that. Nope. So we'll run in here real quick. Grab our ray gun. Drop it onto that bearing. And you don't have to do it this way, but this is the way I like to do it because it really just gives me a little more stability in the build. Or it makes it a little bit easier getting everything lined up and get your angles right. Otherwise, it can become a nightmare. All right. And rotate it around. Put our other bearing on here, like so. We'll connect it up real quick. Grabbing that one. Drag it over, hitting that bearing. All right. And we are just about ready to go here. We'll get our little piece of brick, put that on there, come out another one. Yep, so that we clear our wheels. We'll come on and put right on the face of that, turn it so I can drag down. Boom. And do the same thing to the ground, across like so. Come to the end of the house like that. Across, oops, I won't do that yet. Oops, I missed a spot. So always make sure that you're tying in. Again, I keep saying this. Make sure that you're tying in to the wall and not like the ground or something else like that. If you tie into the wrong piece, it won't work right. Oops, I see I did it again there. What I'm doing, I'm going back and giving myself plenty of room to make sure that I'm affixing to this wall that I'm building, not affixing to the ground or to the house. And then I want to just tie in here. Angle over one. There we go. All right. And I'm going to do the same thing here. There we go. And we can come over here now. And using our controller. Oh, I need to make sure I got my directions on those bearings right. Let's go flip these over. All right. So one is going up in blue. That one needs to go that way in blue. And this one blue needs to go that way in blue because we want to roll and counteract the fact that it's going up. We want to counteract it by twisting the whole thing back down. And we're going 90 blue, 180 blue, 90 blue. So we come back over to this panel and we put three new bearings onto this panel. And we're going to do the same thing with these. I'm going to go 90 blue here. I'm going to go 180 degrees here. And I'm going to go 90 degrees here. And hopefully that is correct. So let's hit our button. And we'll run over to the other side. Uh-oh, something didn't work right. So let's look at what didn't work. Change the direction on that. There we go. Didn't have the direction right. Make sure everything's good. That one went up. That one went that way. That one went down. Yeah, for some reason I keep getting my directions wrong. Yep, went up and down. So here's the next nifty thing that we can do. Is, again, I can get rid of this. This button now raises the wall. Now what I want to do is right after the wall raises up, I want the legs to raise up. So I want it to, you know, basically what I want it to do is I want it to go up and then have the wheels come up and we're ready to roll, right? Well, I can make that one fluid. That's two button presses that I got to do. But I want to make this one fluid motion. Oops. All right. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to ditch this button. I'm going to ditch it. And instead of using that button, I'm going to grab me a couple of pieces of wood here. So let's grab wood. Put that there. And I'm going to need a sensor. Put that there. All right, so here's what we're going to do. I'm going to take a piece of wood, and I'm going to mount it right here, like so. To that, I'm going to mount a sensor. Like, turn that direction around, because I want it on the piece of wood. There we go. Nope, that's the wrong direction there, Moosey. Oops. Now I got a mess. Now I got a hole in the wall. Dink. There, fixed. All right, give me that sensor. All right, sensor, rotate around. There you go. That's the right place. So now what I want to do is I want to mount another piece of wood right here, like so. I want to put a bearing on this side of it. Like that. That bearing is going to be controlled by this box right here. There we go. It's going to be bearing number 7. And I want to make sure that it rotates blue down. I'm going to take and put another wood block on this side of it and another blue block right there. So basically what I've done is I've made a little pivot point here. If I come into E and I come down to bearing number 7, it is in its open position. It's going to be just like this. What I want to do is once this wall has finished running it and it's raised itself up, I then want that piece to rotate itself down 90 degrees. So I'm going to have that rotate down 90 degrees. When I do, this piece of block will then block this sensor, which will then trigger this unit to run. Because the sensor is a switch. All right. Does that make sense to you? So basically what will happen is as that falls down, it blocks the sensor then opens the switch, which starts this project, which will lower down the wheels. In theory, that all works, right? Up, rolls down, the wheels come up. Ha ha, it works. So now when I change this, the whole system on this box is going to run in reverse, which means this is going to roll up, the wheels are going to collapse down, the wall will then come down. So, get it? Well, it's like a basketball. Some ain't working right. Oh, hello. All right. Come on. Wow. That's like a basketball, isn't it? All right, let's see if I can get this thing put on a lift. I gotta get somewhere. Oh, I got it now. Let's get it on the lift. There we go. Ooh, that was nasty. What did not work? Something did not work. Lower that down. It went up just fine. It didn't come back down. Why did it not come down? It shouldn't need to do anything other than just do its thing. 90 degrees, that means it should have gone back up after it was all the way down, and those wheels should have fallen into place. Something did not work right. All right, let's try this again. There, the wheel is open. Is the sensor picking up the wheels? Is that what it is? Is the sensor in a bad position, maybe? Maybe you need to move the sensor up? Let's try this one more time. I think that's what it is. I think the sensor is seeing the back wheels. Got the house grabbed. We'll move it over there. I think that's my problem. I think my sensor is seeing the back wheel. So let's undo all this. Get rid of that. Actually, let's undo that and move that sensor way back here. Let's get rid of that so I can actually do some work here. All right. So if we put the sensor right here, now we're going to need to move that switch. All right. So sensor goes here, maybe. And we get rid of this whole thing, which falls to the ground. Just out of curiosity. All right. So that did not freak out. So that means we're good there. So we'll need a switch. That's good. All right. So we'll put said switch right there. Then we'll put our wooden block here. Put our bearing on our wooden block. There we go. Then we will connect that bearing to that box, that button to that box, that to that. That's good. All right, get a wooden block, put it on there, put that there, go into this box, go back down to 7, go 90 degrees on that. Oops, I don't want it there. I want it on stage 2. Dunk, dunk, there we go. All right, and let's hit this, make sure bearing is in the right direction on that. It is in the wrong direction. There we go. Now we should be good to go. So if we hit E, down, wheels come up, come down. All right, come down. All right, we're good to go. That is done. All right, so phase 1 is complete. That gets us that part of it done. Again, coming over it. Oh, that is sealed up. Nice. All right, so sweet. And oops. Ugh. So what I want to do here, I want to cover up these this area here. Cover that area so you can't see the wheels from the top. There we go. Oops. Cool. And oops. Cool. There. Gotta go there. I gotta get up here. Give myself a block. Come over to the corner. Come over to this corner. Boom. And, oh, nope, 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 don't do that. change the direction. There we go. So what am I doing? I'm giving myself one more layer of block here for aesthetics. And then on the inside of it, I'm going to give myself a little piece of wood to set some stuff on. Oops, that's not what I want to do. Still not what I want to do. There we go. If I didn't want to do it the first time, why would I want to do it a second time? Let's see, I need something to stand on. There we go. Up. Let's come right here. And again, make sure I build off of the actual wall there and bring it up towards the house. Bing, bada boom, bada bing, bada boom. Off the wall towards the house. There we go. Do this again. Oh, come on. Just grab up here. Come back. And boom. All right. Now we have a platform. And we can come in here. And we can get some of our little plants that are in here. And we can just place them randomly up on here. We need something bushy there. Something bushy there for decoration. Yep, something there. Another something there. And, you know, something right there. There we go. Nice. Very nice. And again, if we come in here and we open this up. There we go. So we can see our little panel. There we go. It all raises up. And it works. Sweet. So we're almost done with that portion of it. We'll do the same thing on this side now. So we put our lift. We'll jump up on it. We lift ourselves up. I'm going to select my wood block again. Again, I'm starting in the corner and I'm pulling from the wall towards the house. That way it's not attaching itself to the house. If I were to start here and accidentally hook onto the house and drag over, then this thing wouldn't work because it would be hooked to the house. So again, I'm starting. Oops. Not what I want to do. Starting on the wall and pulling back. There we go. Maybe I can reset the wall now. There we go. And there we go. Let's put some bushies in the front. All right, put one there, another one there, that little guy right there, and then put that guy there, and that guy right there. There we go. All righty, we're decorated up, and we've got a beginning. How about that? All right, so there's the beginning of our little house and our hidden little structure. And again, if I wanted to control all of this from my little seating plot, I just come over here and the button, which is the pinky one, I drag that pink up to the chair. And now I can do the whole thing from the chair. So if I jump up into the chair, you'll see now I have a button on my little hot bar, which position one is the button. Oh, yeah. Oh, we are cooking with hot oil. Nice. So if we wanted, we could slap a motor down here. We have to have more than one, though, because this guy needs some horsepower to get going. So if we come in here, put ourselves... Basically, the way I did the last one was I had a motor for each wheel. All right. And so each set of wheels has a motor. So let's go drive. Make sure you check your drive directions. That one's wrong. That one's wrong. There we go. And we'll take this one up here to there and to there. Check your drive directions. That one's wrong. That one's wrong. Do the same thing here. Over there. And we'll do the same thing here to there. Check our drive directions. Those are right. And then we go. Oops, I don't want to take it away from it. Come on now. And we'll go there. And we'll go there. And those drive directions are correct. Hook all of these up to the little green dot up here. Hook that up to here. Hook that up to there as well. Oops, come on now. Give me your spaghetti. There we go. And last piece of spaghetti goes up to there. Wow, that's a lot of lines, isn't it? All right. Power. Uh-oh. Oh, can't get in. E. One. Drop it down. Dropper, dropper. Dropper. All right, now, let's give these guys a little bit of power. Oops. So I want to take these, not too much power right now, because there's not a whole lot of mass on these. So we're going to go up three dots on each of them. Okay. You are going up. Ta-da. There we go. You, sir, are going up to there. All right, and you are going up to there. There we go. All right, so that is that. Out we go. This is not the permanent position for this seat. This is just a demo. This is where we are temporarily to make sure that we have a functioning vessel. Oh yeah, they're gonna need more power. We're gonna need more power there, boss. Crank them up. Oh, man. I think a wide open might be too much. Okay, that one's there. And then we'll get this one up to here. All right. And then we'll get this one up to about here. There we go. And get this one up to there. All righty. Well, we're getting there, we're getting there, we're getting there. Getting in our seat now. Oh, yep, we're rolling backwards. Get off of this thing. Oh, yeah. Oh, let's see if we can go for a ride. We have no suspension on this. That's the only thing. Oh, look. We went from one pad to the next one. Yes, we decided we wanted to come work over here. Relocating our work facility. Alright, so we have proof of concept. So far, so good. And so far, we're holding frame rates. I wonder if something just went corrupt in that other file. Who knows? Alright, we hit one. Let's fold back in. And no one is any the wiser. How about that? I think that's where we'll stop for now. When we come back, we will put the second floor on, put a roof on this thing, and do a little bit more messing around. So, anyways, hope you guys enjoyed that so far. I will catch you in the next episode. Until then, stay safe. Have a wonderful day. If you like the video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And, yeah, like the video, share it with your friends, and, of course, follow me and subscribe if you haven't subscribed already. I do new videos each and every day. Until next time, guys, we'll see you soon. Bye-bye.